Instagram Inside Explained. In today's video, I'm going to share with you how to read Instagram insights for yourself and for your clients. But before we dive in with the video, if you're new to this channel, I would love for you to subscribe to this channel and click the like button if you like this video. All right, so once you start working with a client at the end of the month, you want to figure out whatever you did was good or not, right? And for that, we want to do statistics or reporting. But if you're just sending your client a random Excel spreadsheet, or even if it's not random and really good, most likely your client won't understand exactly what these numbers mean and if they're good or not. So you wanna, first of all, make sure that you have a monthly call with your client where you explain what these different KPIs mean and if you've reached them or not, and what you're gonna do about it if you didn't reach them, and if you reached them, how you're gonna move the strategy forward, doing more of what's already working. So let's dive in right away in the app. So I'm opening Instagram and I'm gonna go to professional dashboard. So that means for this video, I'm sharing the insights for a business account, an Instagram business account, not creator account, but business account. Why do you need one? Because with a business account, you can connect it to different scheduling tools. Right, I'm gonna click professional dashboard, and it might look slightly different on your end depending on what update you have, also what country you're in. So we're gonna go on a top right, see all, and click there. And this is basically the first page that we're looking at to see how we're doing. So you see it's the last 30 days, and I typically like to do my insights on a weekly basis to see whether I'm on track or not and if I have to maybe adjust my course. So I'm gonna do the last 7 days. And now we see we've reached 90% more accounts than the week before, and we have a higher engagement as well. So when you see such a different or drastic number, you most likely had a viral video or a piece of content that went viral. So this is actually super important to know, because if you think that that's normal and you constantly want to achieve this huge number, you're gonna set yourself up for failure. So you always want to look what was the week before and then establish your baseline. So our goal is always to be better than the week before, right? And if we have a 90% plus, it's most likely we're not gonna reach that the week after. So then we look the week before that week or before that week. So it just shows us that we have a viral piece of content, and we'll see that in a minute, right? So that's the number one I'm gonna look at, account reach. Did we reach more account? And then obviously we're also gonna look at account engage and account more followers. But for now, I wanna stay on that account reached. And for that, I'm gonna go down to content you shared, gonna click see all, and then we're gonna have an overview of all the different posts we did in that last 7 days. And obviously on the top then, we will find out which of these posts actually gave us this huge number of reach that we have 90% more than the week before. And you can see it was a Reels, but it was also a carousel post. So that's super important to notice. And you wanna write that down. If you do any analytics reports, that's something that you want to mention, right? That you had a viral Reels. So that's why I do the account reach. I'm gonna see, okay, it's a number up, and then I'm gonna go and check which part of content actually dragged this number up massively. Because if you look at all the other numbers, we're always around 900 or 800. So we can see that really these two videos were completely different compared to the other ones. So we want to mention this in our reporting. For us, it's basically going mini viral, right? So that's the first statistic that I look at, or the first number that I look at. Then I'm gonna look accounts engaged, and I see, okay, also there we have 26% more. So we're 26% up with accounts engaged. Now we're gonna go down again on content you shared, but we're gonna go on posts. And then we only have one piece of content, but what we could do, I'm gonna share it with you actually with the last 30 days. because it's still not showing us the posts and the reels in the same overview is slightly annoying. But what I wanted to share with you is when we go on to the filter, we can actually sort it by metric. And here I would like it to sort by post interactions to again see why did we achieve 26% more engagement. Of course, it's great, but I wanna figure out why. I wanna reverse engineer that process. If you have a minus, you also want to look at all of these different posts and feel like, why did no one interact? So it doesn't really matter whether you have a plus or a minus. When you look at the statistics, you always want to figure out why. So now I'm going to see, okay, the post that gave us the most interaction was this one here. So I'm going to look at it and dive a bit deeper into the different numbers. How many likes did we get? How many comments did we get? How many saves did we get? And compare it to the week before. So then obviously total followers, it's always great to see how many more followers that we get. But when you do your strategy, you want to figure out what are the KPIs for your clients. Is it to get more followers? Now, if it's an influencer who works with brands, of course, how many followers they have is super important. However, if it's, let's say, a business coach whose most important metric is to get clients, the followers don't necessarily make a big difference, but the engaged accounts are way more important because they can convert these people into clients. Right? So I'm gonna go back on content you shared because I wanna share with you something that even if you use a tool on the computer, like maybe Metricool, etc., where you can see the stats really well, what I love about this one here is that we have that visual overview. So when I look at the last 30 days, apart from this one reels that we have on the top left hand, we can see that my carousel posts mostly overperform my reels in the last 30 days. So that's super important and I can see that right away visually, right? And it's always the same style that has worked really well. So compared to when I then scroll down here, you can see the pictures and the reels already look different. So that's important to remember because when you do it here, you might see right away a visual image. I give you another example. When I used to work as a travel blogger and I was living in Bali, I would post a lot of pictures from rice fields, from snorkeling. And when I went to this visual overview, I also posted cafes. So think of like cafes, rice fields, and pictures of me at the beach. When I was at the beach, that would outperform everything. So literally this overview here, it was just all blues. Like the greens and everything else fell short. So then that showed me, okay, post more blue colors, right? Or post more of that specific beach because people like it. So that's something I really like to see when we're on this overview. Now, when you do your reports, you wanna figure out what kind of content has performed the best that month. You wanna figure out why that content has performed so well. You're looking at the account reached, you're looking at the engagement, you're also looking or at least reporting the followers that went up, and you're gonna go in depth into the analytics of each post that you did the last week, and you're gonna look at why do we think this post has gained so much traction, and then you can write it down in a PDF and send it to the client. But again, I prefer to go on a call with a client and explain them what I've just figured out and then tell them what I'm gonna do more of, what I'm gonna do less of. So I do it on a weekly basis and just for myself, and then I go on the monthly call with the client and tell them what my learnings are. So this is just a quick overview on how you can analyze your posts. You can do the same with stories. So you're just gonna click down here on stories and then you have the same overview. And like I mentioned before, on the top right hand, we can sort by different metrics. So I could see how the link clicks were which obviously for many businesses is super important, right? Which stories gave me the most link clicks? And link clicks is always hard to get because obviously IG doesn't really love it. So typically the reach is lower. But as you can see, the one where I shared that I'm looking for an intern, which by the way, it's finished now, so don't apply. That one got the most story clicks or link clicks. Also, if you want to be in the loop for future internships, make sure you follow us on IG. And if you want to learn a bit more about how to even get started as a social media manager, because you just stumbled on that video, make sure you watch my free masterclass and subscribe to this channel. So let's go back. So we have these different metrics on the filter. We can do link clicks, we can do impressions, we can do profile visits, etc. But really to me, it's the link clicks that I look at, and then maybe also how many people clicked next story. And then obviously I'm gonna do the exact same thing on Reels. So I'm gonna go on here and I can check if I have several Reels, which one performed best. Again, I only posted one in the last week, so I'm looking at the last 30 days, and you can see we had one Reels that was outperforming everything, and it was a Canva feature. Now, this is just a quick snippet of what you can do in statistic wise. Obviously, there's way more to it. If you're interested in that, make sure you join my course on how to become a social media manager, or subscribe to this channel and watch out for new videos. That's just one part, the Instagram part. We're also gonna do the statistics for all the different social media channels that we are managing as a social media manager. And I've touched on it quickly. If you wanna work with the tool, Metricool has good statistics. For Instagram, I actually also like Iconosquare has also some good statistics. But basically, if you're just get starting, look at the insight on the phone, see what you can figure out and how you can improve your content. Instagram is only one part that you will work with as a social media manager, and another one is definitely TikTok. So I'm gonna link another video here after this where you can check out the basics on how to do TikTok. So make sure you check that out as well. And if you have any questions, as always, let me know below this video. See you in the next one.